The project two is collage, and I want you to have two different collage and choose one for your painting. So that's probably something you should think about. Okay, you try to make two different collages, and it's not collage is not due until Monday, but I think it's good to start to think today. Okay, so I got those calendar, it's originally calendar, right? And I got these two pages just pulled out from calendar. And you start to look at some newspaper or magazine and maybe start to cut something you are interested in. Okay? Maybe you can just cut something from fashion magazine or like whatever you have, or maybe newspaper, and start to cut something you're interested in. Okay? Also, you can cut some construction papers if you want. So some shapes can be coming from construction paper. Okay? Maybe your construction paper with a different colors. Okay? And now, once you get to have enough material, you can start to think about how you can compose on each calendar background. Maybe having these two are too similar, and maybe it's better to spread. Maybe, shall I have this lady in this urban house, or shall I have this lady in the middle of the field? And maybe you can have some additional shapes. Maybe this is a little bit too big, so I can just have something here. Sometimes when you cut the magazine, maybe on the back side can be more interesting than front side. So originally I cut this image to cut this shape of the leg, but then I flipped that, oh, there's something more interesting in the background. So start to think about what kind of collage you can make. I'm recommending to have a calendar photograph as a big background in order to minimize the white space. But if you don't have anything like calendar background, you could be having just all these compositions on the white background too. But idea is try to not to have more than 20% of the white space on your collage. That's something you should think about. Okay, so having a calendar big photograph may help for reducing white background. You can make black and white photograph as your collage. It's actually better to have black and white collage than you have freedom of color. Collage become traced onto Bristol, and then you paint with the color scheme of your choice. For example, this one is coming from this collage, and then I paint it with acrylic paint. Okay, then this one I use the primary triad, which is blue, yellow, red, and how I have green and orange, because you are allowed to mix those hues you choose. So I made a orange by mixing yellow and red, and I made a green by mixing yellow and blue, okay? But bottom line is the value of the collage has to, a value of a painting has to be matching to the value of the collage. Okay, so if you have an iPhone, whatever smartphone, that makes your job much easier. Or, just you don't have to make a Xerox. you can just occasionally take photograph, take photograph of your collage. So and make a grayscale. And when you are painting, sometimes you'll be taking photograph and convert into grayscale. So you can see how the value of the collage and value of the painting will be is matching. Okay, so that's how you progress.